Hi, my name is Soas from Origin, and this is my basic champion guide to Poppy. In solo queue for Poppy, for the lane, you'll usually try to farm with the potions that you have early on. As soon as you have your Shen, you can start to play aggressive for your Phage. The good matchup overall are gonna be the melees, since your spells are have quite a low distance. You can get kited quite easily against, like, for example, Gnar or Lulu or this kind of champions, but you do quite well against tanks. I think tanks are the easiest matchup, if I can say that, because you can farm easier and you get your items and then you'll probably win against them. Against Bruiser, it's probably 50-50 and it's the same. As soon as you have your Shen and a longsword or something like this, you'll probably win. For lane, you'll usually prioritize the farm over aggression early. So as long as you have your potion and you didn't base, you'll prioritize CS over everything. Try to get your Shen and longsword if you can, and then you can start playing a lot more aggressive. It's also really hard to gank Poppy as soon as she hits level 6 due to her R being able to throw enemies really far. So she's qu as soon as you hit 6, you're quite safe on lane. Still by wards, obviously. If you're playing as the melee and he's trying to be over aggressive, try to be in a good position to hit your stun and harass him. Don't stay too much on him after stunning. Just do your combo and the Thunderlord is gonna proc and then you just back off. So you'll probably deal like 50% of his HPs and then you just do it again to kill him. For Poppy in teamfight, depending of the position of your team and the enemy team, you'll usually try to focus the target that you can stun on the wall. So it's gonna be either the front line, either the back line, depending of whoever goes in. If their tank play over aggressive, you can just go on them and R their back line and focus the tanks. If it's the opposite, you can maybe try to flank and get a good stun on their backliner and just R him to the wall again. So if you flank their AD carry or their APs, just try to stun them, do your combo and back off if you're playing DPS. Don't stay too long because you're gonna be squishy and you can die really fast. If you play tank, it's a bit easier, so try to tank as much damage as you can so your allies can DPS and then just flash out. You often can catch enemies off guard if they are a bit overextended or anything like this due to your mobility. If you have Swiftnet boost, for example, and you activate your W, you're gonna be really fast. And you can also like E a minion and get to your target a lot faster. Especially if you have like Desmond plate, you can just hit him once and then you'll have your E back and can catch him quite easily. If you play Poppy, you're quite mobile due to your W. So after pushing your lane, if you don't want to base necessarily, you can just try to roam off to mid and get a kill or get a really good shank for your mid lane to have an advantage. Some other nice tips: if you stun someone to a wall and Q him, also you can R him straight after your Q procs. So he's gonna get a really small stun next to the wall, so you can just wait for your cooldowns again and have a bit more DPS than if you'll auto them. For the runes, I will go HP yellows, AD reds, AD queens, MR blues versus APs or MR per level, and CDR per level myself. I would rather go for CDR level myself due to the fact that it's really hard to get CDR right now, so I value CDR per level for a lot of champions really highly. For the masteries, if you wanna go tanky, I would rather go for 0, 12, 18 and go for tanky build. If you wanna go for more DPS, I will probably go for the 12-18. Basic one for most of the bruisers. I personally prefer the 12-18 myself, due to the famous Thunderlord, because you kind of have a burstish playstyle and it's a bit the same as the old Poppy, so you kind of have the role of an assassin rather than a tank, so I prefer this kind of playstyle for my. For the skill order, I usually start with Q. Then depending of what summon I have, if I have Ignite, I'll probably go with E and trying to harass a lot. If I have TP and I wanna sit and farm, I'll take W second for level second. And you max Q over everything, then E, then W with obviously taking all the R spell when you can. You usually you just max E over W because of the burst that you can have. If you stun someone, you can pretty much one-shot anyone, so it's just for this fact, really. You can go for two different builds on Poppy due to being able to play her as an annoying tank or also as a burst assassin DPS. For the tanky build, start with a corruption of potion into Sunfire. Buy the boots whenever you can, Mercury's if there is many stuns or Swiftness if there is many slows, Black Cleaver or Frozen Mallet, it's gonna depend on you, into a Danceman plate and usual tanky build depending of whoever is fed, APs or ADs. For the DPS build, start with a corruption potion as well. Shin if you have the gold for it, either otherwise you'll probably go for a Phage instead with the components. Then you go for Trinity, same for the other ones, Swiftness boots if there is slows, Mercury's if there is stuns, Danceman plate for a second item, Spectre's Crawl if you're playing versus an AP, then you go for Danceman plate, then you can finish your Spirit Visage or go for a Banshee and continue with some tanky items. Thanks for watching, guys, and make sure to check out the rest of the guides over at lolclass.com.